Hello Techies. In the previous tutorial, we have learned how to work with run JavaScript action. Now, in this tutorial, we will learn how to work with run JavaScript function on web page action in Power Automate Desktop. Run JavaScript function on web page action functions similarly to the run JavaScript action. If you want to use JavaScript to handle and alter web elements, we can use the run JavaScript function on web page action. But it executes code on loaded web pages. Using JavaScript, we can handle virtually any element on web pages, such as text boxes and images. The main difference between these two actions about the input is the browser instance that the run JavaScript function on the web page also requires. The result is stored in the variable produced, that is result, which action does not provide separate variables for the potential errors. The JavaScript function field automatically creates the structure of the predefined JavaScript function. Now, if you see the parameters of the run JavaScript function on the web page, we are having first one web browser instance. On which browser instance that we want to run this JavaScript? Another one, JavaScript function. If you observe over here, this is predefined over here, which is already having function execute script, and you are going to write the code for the script over here inside these curly brackets, right? And the output will be stored inside the variables produced. All right. Now, let me show you a small real-time example over here. Now, if you see on my screen, I'm having a web page where we are having the documents vault related videos over here. There you can see the URL. I'm having docsvault.com/resources/product videos. These are all about the videos which I am having for the docs vault. I will give the same URL in the description below. And if you observe over here, I'm having the images and the videos related to that one. All right, there are almost all 16 different types of videos which we are having. Now, each and every video over here, this is the image over here where it will show the image of that particular video. And then if you click on that video, it will place in a separate window. Now, let me click on the video over here that if you click on the image, it will open a new pop-up window and there a video will be played over here related to that image, right? Now, if you observe over here that I'm having the images over here, but I need to get the YouTube URLs also. How can I go ahead and get it? That is by using run JavaScript function on web page action, we can go ahead and we can get it. That is our major agenda. But before that, now I will get all the values over here by using unified recorder. So Unified Recorder, we got it as a new update as part of December 2021. It's a release we got it, which has been unified web recorder as well as the desktop recorder. All right. Now, let me start recording over here. Let me click on recorder. And then I'm going to click on record to start our recording or the actions of steps which we are going to perform on the application. Let's click on record. Now, if you mouse over on the each and every section, there we can see I'm having images over here. You can get it, IMG over there. And then if you right click on that to extract the elements, I can go ahead, right click, extract element value. And then I'm going to get it the source of the particular image. And in the same way, I'm going to select another image where you can see IMG over here in the web page. Right click, extract element value. And then I'm going to select the source once again. Then you can see when I'm going to extract the data, so what it will happen, it will convert the values into the extract data and then it will store the entire values which we are going to, similar kind of actions it will do, and then it will get all the images data inside the output data variable. All right, let me click on finish. Now if you observe, I got launch new Chrome action as well as extract data from the web page, that is https://www.docsvault.com/resources/product product videos, right? Now we'll see the output, what kind of data that we are going to get it whenever we are going to extract the data from the web page action. All right, let's run the flow to see the output. Flow execution started. There you can see I'm not going to close the web browser so that it will be run at the back end, right? Now let me go ahead, let me see the data over here. Now I got the data as output data. Let's click on that. There you can see in the output data, in the results that I got, all the images which are I'm having in the web page. There you can see I'm having 16 images, so that I got from starting from index 0 to 16 for each and every content that we are having inside my web page. There you can see I'm having 16 pages, so that 16 images, so that all the 16 images have been captured or extracted by using extract data on web page action. But my agenda is that I need to extract the YouTube link of the particular video. If you see in my web page, I'm having 16 images over there, right? Or 16 divisions that I'm having, each and every image having one YouTube link. I need to get that YouTube link. How can I go ahead and get that? That can be achieved by using run JavaScript function on web page. All right. Now, before that, let me show you how can we get the links by using inspect element. Right click on the web page. There you can see I'm having inspect. Click on that. And then I'm going to select this arrow over here, that is select an element in the web page to inspect. Right, I'm going to select that, and then I'm going to mouse over on the particular image. Right, there you can see I'm having the same image which we have seen, like image1.png or the interface-covers-image1.png. Right, for the same one, if you observe over here, I'm having the YouTube URL over here, that is a title and href, that you are having the YouTube link over here, that is YouTube/, and the video link over here has been given over here to autoplay this one, right? And I'm going to select another image. There you can see I'm having mobileapp.png, and the same way we are having the link of the YouTube over here. I need to capture this one. How can I go ahead and capture it? How can I get the data of the particular video, or you know, the entire videos which we are having inside the web page? Now, to make you understand, I'm going to click on console, and then I'm going to use the console app over here to get the image, to get the video links over here. How can I go ahead and get it? First of all, I'm going to use document.query string. If you observe over here inside the elements, if you are going to select over here, I'm having content container. This is the div container. If you mouse over on anything, that if you see, I'm having content container for each and every video, right? I'm going to select this class over here, which I'm going to use it. And then I'm going to use the href over here, that is hyperlink for the reference, right? There you can get it, the YouTube link for the particular video, right? Now I'm going to do the in the same way by using query selector. All right, let me show you the output by using console, and I'm going to use document.querySelector.contentContainer. It's the ahref I'm going to use it. A means anchor, that I'm going to use it, and the href, I'm going to use it as the hyperlink. All right, there you can see I got the link of the YouTube. If you observe over here, that I'm having 16 different videos. Now in that case, how can I go ahead and get it? Now I'm going to use it same thing, but we're going to use query selector all, right? Let me click on that. Now I'm going to use it over here, that is document.query selector all, that whatever the containers with the same name, I'm having all the containers inside the anchor, and then I'm going to get the attribute of the href. But if you observe, I'm having zero, index starts with zero and one, two, three, and so on, so that I will get each and every href of that one. If I want to get it another one, there I'm going to give the index as one over here, and then I'm going to click on enter. There you can see for the first index, that is index 0, that I'm going to get it the first YouTube link. For the second one, I'm going to get web access on mobile app. Then I'm going to get it the same YouTube link over here. In the respective way, I will get all the YouTube links over there in the web page, right? Now, the same values, I need to pass it to the run JavaScript function on web page action. Then you can get it all the values which are there inside my web page, all right? Now, let me drag and drop this run JavaScript function on web page action onto the workspace. Inside that, I'm having the parameters. First parameter is that web browser instance. So we are going to give it the browser which we have launched by using launch new Chrome. All right. And the JavaScript function, just we have executed one of the JavaScript function on the console application, right? The same JavaScript, I'm going to use it over here. That is document.querySelectorsAll with the content hyphen container of 0 with the anchor, and I'm going to get the attribute of href, right? This value I'm going to store it in a variable called var result, okay? And the same result I'm going to return it. I'm going to write it as return result. All right. So this result will be stored inside the result, that is variable produce, that is result over here. Now I will make it as href result. All right, let me click on save. And then let's run the flow to see the output. Flow execution started. There you can see inside my output, I got 16 rows, and the href, I got the output over here. There you can see the YouTube link over here, right? This is the first link which I have given as 0, right? That's why I'm going to get it as 0. To make you understand, I have already developed the desktop flow. By using launch new Chrome, I have launched that is www.docsvault.com/resources/product-videos. And then I'm going to extract the data into the output data, right? And then if you observe, I'm going to launch an Excel. So what is the purpose of this Excel? If you see, I'm going to store the data. First one is the image URL, another one as YouTube URL. So which we're having for each and every video. And I'm going to store each and every record over here inside this Excel, right? Now, I'm going through the loops by using for each action from the output data that I'm going to increase by using the set variable. I have given it as new variable. And then the main content is the run JavaScript function, right? Run JavaScript function on web page. If you click over there, if you observe over here, I'm having function execute script over here. So that I'm having var result, that is document.querySelectorAll with the container, that is content container, and the anchor A I have given as a JavaScript. And if you observe, I have given previously as 0, 1, and so on, right? Now, I need to get that index. So from where I will get the index over here, that is variable that I'm having new var, that is the variable name which I have given, so that I'm going to get the values over there. But I have initiated with the 2, so that I'm going to decrease by 2 over here. That is new var minus 2, that is starts with 0 over here. And then the output will be stored inside the href, that is href result as an output. All right, for each and every row, for each and every index that I'm going to get the value and storing inside the href. All right, let me click on save. Now, the href result as an output, which we are going to get it, we are going to write it into the write to Excel worksheet inside the new column, that is YT URL, right? At the same time, I'm going to write the Excel worksheet also inside the column, that is image URL, right? That is in the first column, and the second column we are having YouTube URL. And the same Excel, I'm going to save it by using save Excel action. All right, and finally, we are going to close the browser. So the main thing is run JavaScript function on web page, which we are going to use it as part of this tutorial. All right, let's run the flow to see the output. Flow execution started. There you can see on the topmost where it has been launched a new Chrome window, that is docsvault.com/productvideos, and then it is trying to extract the data by using extract data from web page. There you can see it has been extracted the data into the output data, right? And after that, it has launching a new Excel, which has been launched over here. And then it is going to write the data into the write to Excel worksheet. There you can see each and every row, it is going to be write the data over here. The first one is image URL, and the second one is the YouTube URL, which we are going to get it by using run JavaScript function on web page action. Once it has been completed, it is going to save the Excel, and then it is going to be closing the browser. All right, if you observe over here, the image URL, which we got it, all the image URLs on the image URL column. Another one, YT URL, that is YouTube URL from the particular web page, that I got it, all the YouTube links over here, which it is not possible by using extract UI elements, extract elements, which it is not possible, right? I hope you understand how to work with run JavaScript function on web page action as part of this tutorial. So by using this action, we can code on loaded web pages, and also we can handle virtually any element on the web page, such as text boxes and images on the particular web page by using this action. Thank you for watching Power Automate tutorials. If you have any queries related to this concept, please post them in the comment section. I will see you in the next session. Till then, bye-bye. Have a wonderful day.